Aaron Burnett Out Front, weeknights at 7, only on CNN.
A mob of cameras nearly crushing the man who leads Asiana Airlines as he arrived in San Francisco International. The somber president trying to express condolences. But he was forced back inside the terminal as reporters shouted questions. The biggest one, what happened inside the cockpit? The man behind the controls as Asiana Flight 214 crashed was the co-pilot, making his very first landing at San Francisco International in a 777. The NTSB says he had just 35 hours in that aircraft, far more junior than his supervisor, who had landed 777s at this airport 33 times. With no recorded distress calls before landing, part of the NTSB's investigation will be examining cockpit communication and culture.
We need to understand what was going on in the cockpit.
Communication in Korean cockpits raises an alarm to USC aviation safety professor Naj Mishkati, who has studied culture in cockpits for two decades. In the 80s and 90s, Korea's largest airline, Korean Air, suffered a series of accidents, including Flight 801 in Guam in 1997. And the airline was criticized for its authoritarian culture in the cockpit. Then in 1999, Korean Air Cargo 8509 plunged into a village near London. The investigation later revealed the junior officers were so deferential to the captain that they failed to speak up before it was too late. Social hierarchy and deference to elders is paramount in Korean culture. While Korean aviation today has safety standards rated among the highest in the world, Mishkati says hierarchical cultures can lead subordinates to stay quiet even in the face of safety problems.
If you have that cultural norm that doesn't help or it's not conducive to this type of a behavior, then you cannot have an appropriate level of the questioning attitude, which is a requirement for safety culture.
The unspoken rules of Korean culture may also help explain this curious comment by Asiana 214 flight attendant Yoon-hee Lee. Immediately after the plane stopped skidding after the crash, Lee went to the captain. I knocked on the cockpit door, she says. The captain opened it and I asked, are you okay, captain? And he said, yes, I'm okay. I asked, should I perform an evacuation? And he told me to wait.
It is important to note that we don't know exactly what happened in the cockpit. We will learn that at the end of this investigation. And something I would like to add, Aaron, there is an intense reaction within the country of Korea. Koreans have a deep connection to the global community through the products that its companies produce, like Samsung, Hyundai, Asiana. And they are feeling it intensely in the country that this is a black eye for all Koreans.